We've got intel on a converted fishing boat near Puerto Grande. It's being used as a cocaine lab. Find the lab and destroy it.
Buckle up, people.
I was remembering this time me and my boy Javi went to this party on that East 38th Street hood in LA. We didn't roll with those carnales, but I was sweating this mora whose brother was in with them real deep. Javi and me was like 15 or something, 14. And like the young bloods we were, we wanted to come through the door looking hard, cabrones pues. But Javi, man, that fucker was always stoned. So when we were on the way there, he saw this red taco truck on the corner. His case of the munchies made him stop for a fucking enchilada. Yo, after he ate, we rolled through the door of that party in our crispy white tees and our fucking 501s, and I thought we looked dope. Those plebes were about 2 seconds away from giving us that upward head nod that means respect, right? But then, fucking Javi runs through the party, shoving motherfuckers aside, knocking bitches over, and he jumps into the bathroom and lets loose with diarrhea so goddamn explosive, I swear to God, you could hear it over the music. We sure as fuck didn't look so duro then, and I sure as fuck wasn't gonna get with that vieja I was sweating. So I turned my ass around and left that party before any motherfucker could ask my name. As for Javi, he made it out alive. Turns out, all those fuckers knew that red taco truck and knew it was bad news. They felt bad for the pendejo. If I remember right, he actually jumped them in a month later. This is DJ Perico getting nostalgic on Santa Blanca Radio.
Fucking hell! Sorry about this, brother, but I gotta have the car. Out.
Hello. All right, let's roll.
Esto es Radio Santa Blanca.
Welcome back to SB Radio, and with you as always, your lovable, adorable, completely fuckable DJ Perico. Alright, so with the noise surrounding the bombing of the U.S. Embassy starting to die down a little bit, all of the strange details of the incident are starting to come into focus for your Perico. And not just the details, neta, but also the gaps in the story, the blank spaces where nothing's been drawn. Everybody is blaming, or crediting depending who you ask, is blaming this bombing on the Santa Blanca cartel. Bueno, no one within the cartel has claimed responsibility, and when you bomb somebody, you want people to know you did it, right? Es como, if you didn't kill a motherfucker, you at least want to scare a motherfucker. Now, in public, the cartel has not denied responsibility. But I know for a fact that all the buchones in the cartel know that this bombing was not done by Santa Blanca. So who bombed the embassy? Like I said, there are more details coming to light, such as the death of Ricky and Pomonudo Sandoval, so close on the heels of this bombing. And how come nobody died in the explosion, huh? And why bomb an embassy in the first place? Why hasn't the government released any details of the investigation? Está cabrón. Is this another fucking government cover-up? Well, drop a line to DJ Perico if you know the truth behind this conspiracy.
Estás en Radio SB.
Hola, hermanos. Mi nombre es Rodolfo El Che. Many of you know me, and I am proud to call many of you mis amigos. Some of you close to me have told me of concerns about the cartel. Concerns that I know you all share. I respect the Earth Mother Nuestra Pachamama as much as the rest of you. I have my entire life. I have taught disrespect for Pachamama to my children, and I will teach it to their children. Pachamama must keep in balance and harmony with the cosmos. And that is why I am happy that our country is working with Santa Blanca. This is not the same secular industrialization that the Gringos and their CIA have tried to force upon us. This Mexican organization is...
This is Nidia Flores. If you're a buchona like I am, your entire life people have called you bossy, Mandona. For me, my mother was the first person to call me Mandona. Then it was the other niños at school. As I got older, was boyfriends, co-workers, and let's be honest, my mother has never stopped calling me Mandona. People say it's because they expect a woman to be classy and sweet. O sea, there are even some women out there so upset.
Hang back, we see you.
We got a sniper, here. Get down!
Shit, he knows he's taking fire. The lieutenant's escaping.
Shit balls. Frag out. cartel commendation here. Coordinates here. Looks like the location of a coca paste lab in Okoro.
You want to check it out?
Absolutely. The more we disrupt El Emisario's operations, the more pressure we put on him to come out of hiding.
Got him.
We're clear.
Hang on, I'll drive.
Better not roll this thing.
Coming up on the objective. Let's get this done quick. Get aboard, find a way to destroy the lab, then get clear.
Boss, we ain't got enough charges to sink this bitch. You got any ideas?
Everything we need's right here. All we gotta do is turn on the gas. Gas is running. Now all we need is a spark.
Then we run like hell?
We most definitely run like hell. Job's done. Let's get the hell off this boat before it explodes.
They're gonna be on top of us in another few seconds. What do we
do? Move your asses. Wait.
Sniper!
Move your asses. This thing's about to blow.
Man down. Sniper, down. Sniper, get down. plan on letting me bleed all day?
Hang on, I'm coming.
Damn, that's gonna hurt in the morning.
Shit, we got a sniper!
Engaging tangos.
You're in bad shape. Take cover.